Members of the Presidency, authorities, distinguished guests. I feel honored by your valuation of my work with Gennady Chibisev, who passed away in 2008 on the quantum origin of the structure of the universe. I am delighted to accept this remarkable award and very pleased to share it with Professor Hawking, who independently, using different methods, came to the same conclusion. At the beginning of the 80s, when we wrote the paper, cosmology was still the field of wild speculations, with only one and a half solidly established facts. It was impossible even to imagine that the four robust prediction of the theory, based on the simple idea that the galaxies, their clusters, stars, and planets emerge from quantum fluctuation, could ever be checked. Moreover, at the beginning of the 80s, all these predictions were in serious conflict with all available astrophysical data. However, astrophysical data usually suffer from uncontrolled systematic, and this gave us hope that our theory was not yet completely ruled out. Cosmology became a real science only with the discovery of the cosmic microwave background fluctuation by cosmic background explorer satellite at the beginning of the 90s. COBE observation delivered us the picture of the young universe when it was only 300,000 years old. However, this picture was not yet detailed enough to talk about confirmation or falsification of theoretical prediction. Thanks to remarkable technological progress and heroic efforts of our experimentalist colleagues, during the last 25 years, it became possible to check the most refined prediction of the theory of the quantum origin of the universe structure. At the beginning of this millennium, the result of the measurement of numerous ground-based balloon experiment and finally two-space WMAP and Planck mission came into full agreement with the prediction of the theory, leaving no alternative to it. In particular, the most non-trivial prediction of the logarithmic growth of the amplitude of gravitational potential with the scale was confirmed by Planck measurement at the spectacular 7 sigma level. Among those experimentalists to whom I feel indebted for their tremendous contribution in establishing the truth about our universe, I would like to thank especially Lyman Page, Pablo de Bernardis, Andrew Lange, and Jean-Luc Puget. Answering the question, why do we need cosmology, Professor Weinberg in his book, The First 3 Minutes, wrote, "The efforts to understand the universe is one of the very few things that lifts human life a little above the level of farce." I believe that with the development of the precision cosmology, we have made a step in the right direction. Thank you.